When an airplane begins to move faster than the speed of sound, it creates a shockwave that produces a well-known boom of sound. Now, researchers at MIT have discovered a similar process in a sheet of graphene, in which a flow of electric current can, under certain circumstances, exceed the speed of slowdown light and produce a kind of optical boom, an intense, focused beam of light. This entirely new way of converting electricity into visible radiation is highly controllable, fast and efficient, and could lead to a wide variety of new applications. The new finding started from a fascinating observation. The researchers found that when light strikes a sheet of graphene, which is a two-dimensional form of the element carbon, it can slow down by a factor of a few hundred. That dramatic slowdown, they noticed, presented an interesting coincidence. The reduced speed of photons, that is particles of light, moving through the sheet of graphene happened to be very close to the speed of electrons as they moved through the same material. Graphene has this ability to trap light in modes called surface plasmons. Plasmons are kind of virtual particle that represents the oscillations of electrons on the surface. The speed of these plasmons through the graphene is a few hundred times slower than light in free space. This effect dovetailed with another of graphene's exceptional characteristics, that is, electrons pass through it at very high speeds, up to a million meters per second, or about 1/300 the speed of light in a vacuum. That meant that two speeds were similar enough that significant interactions might occur between the two kinds of particles if the material could be tuned to get the velocities to match. That combination of properties, slowing down light and allowing electrons to move very fast, is one of the unusual properties of graphene. That suggested the possibility of using graphene to produce the opposite effect, to produce light instead of trapping it. This conversion is made possible because the electronic speed can approach the light speed in graphene, breaking the light barrier. Just as breaking the sound barrier generates a shockwave of sound. In the case of graphene, this leads to the emission of a shock wave of light trapped in two dimensions. The phenomenon the team has harnessed is called the Chernokov effect, first described 8 years ago by Soviet physicist Pavel Chernokov. There are many different ways of converting electricity into light, from the heated tungsten filaments that Thomson Edison perfected more than a century ago, to fluorescent tubes, to the light-emitting diodes LEDs that power many display screens and are gaining favor for household lighting. But this new plasmon-based approach might eventually be part of more efficient, more compact, faster and more tunable alternatives for certain applications. Perhaps most significantly, this is a way of efficiently and controllably generating plasmons on a scale that is compatible with current microchip technology. Such graphene-based systems could potentially be key on-chip components for the creation of new light-based circuits, which are considered a major new direction in the evolution of computing technology toward ever smaller and more efficient devices. Using light instead of flowing electrons as the basis for moving and storing data has the potential to push the operating speeds 6 orders of magnitude higher than what is used in electronics. In other words, in principle, up to a million times faster. One problem faced by researchers trying to develop optically based chips is that while electricity can be easily confined within wires, light tends to spread out inside a layer of graphene. However, under the right conditions, the beams are very well confined.